وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. Today inshallah ta'ala the first manners that I wanted to speak about is al-haya shyness. From one of the greatest characteristics and etiquettes that a person can adorn himself with is al-haya shyness. And this term al-haya mushtaqun, it is rooted from and it's taken from min al-hayat, life. Lidhalika, the scholars, they mention fakullama adhumat al-hayat, every time a person's life becomes great in their heart, adhum al-hayat, the shyness becomes great as well. So every single time your life becomes better, your shyness also becomes better. So they're connected. And every single time your life becomes weak in your heart and in your soul, ضعف الحياة, the shyness also becomes weak. ولذلك عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, من قل حياؤه قل ورعه. Anyone whose shyness decreases, قل ورعه, his fear of doubtful issues also reduces. Yani, wara means if something is doubtful, whether it's halal or haram, to stay away from it. That reduces as well. The person starts to dwell in that which is impermissible and haram. If your shyness goes low, committing haram becomes easy for you. وَمَنْ قَلَّ وَرَعُهُ مَاتَ قَلْبُهُ. And when your wara goes, your heart, it dies. Ibn Abi Dunya narrated this in his kitab Makarimul Akhlaq. So this shows us that a person's life and shyness are connected. And when your life reduces, your shyness also reduces. And once your shyness reduces, your wara reduces. You're a person who dwells into that which is haram, and commits that which is haram. And also your heart then dies from this. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us shyness, give us wara, and protect our hearts from dying. Haya, my beloved brothers and sisters, shyness is ma'danul akhlaq. Shyness is the source of good manners. It is manba'ul mu'amalat al-karima. People's good interactions, where it springs from, is shyness. Every single good, as the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us, comes from shyness. Shyness doesn't come except that with, except with that which is good, the Prophet told us, alayhi salatu wasalam. Imran ibn Husayn, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasalam said, Al-haya'u la ya'ti illa bi khayrin, muttafaqun alayhi. Shyness does not bring except good. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated that. The person who's shy, who's got shyness in them, nothing comes from them except that which is good. Abi Qatada, he said, "Kunna 'inda Imran ibn Husayn." Abi Qatada said, "We were in the gathering of Imran ibn Husayn. Imran ibn Husayn is a noble companion. Fi rahtin minna, a group of us. Wa fina Bushayr ibn Ka'b. And with us was Bushayr ibn Ka'b. Bushayr ibn Ka'b was with us. فحدثنا عمران بن حسين يومئذ. عمران بن حسين spoke to us that day. He had a conversation with us. He told us something. And from the things that he told us was that he said to us, الحياء خير كله. عمران بن حسين's noble companion said to us that shyness is all good. All of shyness is good. There's no bad shyness. Or he said, الحياء كله خير. That all of shyness is good. Bushayr ibn ibn Ka'b, he responded to Imran ibn Husayn, and he said, "Inna la najidu fi ba'd al kutubi aw al hikma." We find in some books or some wisdoms, we find anna minhu sakina, that some shyness has tranquility, wa waqar, wa minhu da'fun, and some shyness has weakness. And there's a good shyness and there's a bad shyness. This is what Bushayr ibn Hakam, Bushayr ibn Ka'b is saying. Imran ibn Husayn, he got angry. فغضب عمران. Imran got angry. حتى حمرتا عيناه, until his eyes became red. وقال, he said, ألا أراني أحدثك عن رسول الله. Am I not telling you about the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ وتعارض فيه. And then here you are contradicting what the Messenger said. Because what did the Prophet say? The Prophet said, all of shyness is good. And Bushayr ibn Ka'b is saying what? Some shyness comes with tranquility and good, and some shyness comes with weakness. Imran ibn Husayn said, are you contradicting what I told you about the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? فعاد عمران الحديث. Imran went back to the story. فعاد بشير فغضب عمران. Imran became very angry when he repeated again Bushayr. And he said, فَمَا زِلْنَا نَقُولُ فِيهِ إِنَّهُ مِنَّا يَا أَبَا نُجَيْدٍ. The people that were sitting there, they tried to calm down Imran ibn Husayn, and they said to him, he's from us. There's no problem. He's from us. What I want to take from this hadith is, this hadith tells us, informs us, that the person who's shy, the person who possesses this quality of shyness, this person is upon all of good. Don't ever think to yourself, my beloved brother and my beloved sister, don't ever think to yourself that being shy is a weakness. Remember that shyness is always good. We're in a society today, we're in a time when a person who has shyness is said to, look at this child, look at this kid. We ridicule the shy person instead of praising him for this great trait that he has and telling him that it's a good thing that they have shyness in them. Any individual who's adorned with this quality, then it shows that this person's intellect, this person's aql is complete, haqiqatan, and that this person possesses good manners. And that this person, through their shyness, inshallah ta'ala, they're going to achieve a lot of good. As the poet said, يعيش المرء مستحيا بخير. The person will live as long as he possesses the quality of shyness. The person is going to live with good. ويبقى العود ما بقي اللحاء. And also the tree will remain as long as it has a branch that it stands on. The root is still there. So يعيش المرء مستحيا بخير. As long as you possess the quality of shyness, you will live a good life, inshallah ta'ala. Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he mentioned that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Imanu bid'un wa sab'una shu'bah, that the Iman is 60 odd branches. A'laha qawlu la ilaha illallah, the highest branch is la ilaha illallah. Wa adnaha, and the lowest is imatatu al-adha an al-tariq, it is to remove harm from the streets and the path. والحياء شعبة من شعب الإيمان, and shyness is a branch from the branches of al-Iman. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated that. In this hadith, it explains to us, it shows us that the Iman ليست خصلة واحدة. Iman is not just one branch, or it's not just one characteristics. Iman is شعب كثيرة, it has many branches, it has many good deeds inside it, many qualities. But the highest one is what? La ilaha illallah. Kalimatul ikhlas. And at-tawheed is the highest level. The highest branch is la ilaha illallah. Wa adnaha, and the lowest of it, it is to take off harm from the street. Yani it is to remove everything that will cause a harm to a person. Whether it be a stone, whether it be a thorn, whether it be a glass, or other than that, to remove it from the road. And shyness was mentioned in this hadith. that shyness is what? Min shu'ab al-iman. It's a branch from the branches of iman. And every single time a person increases in shyness, his iman increases. And shyness, brothers and sisters, is wa huwa khayru kullu. It is all good, the shyness. وَلَا يَأْتِي إِلَّا بِخَيْرٍ. Shyness will not bring you except good. Abdullah ibn Umar, رضي الله تعالى عنهما, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, he said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has said, الْحَيَاءُ وَالْإِيمَانُ قُرِنَا جَمِيعًا, that shyness and iman have been both mentioned together. فَإِذَا رُفِعَ أَحَدُهُمَا, if one of them is removed, رُفِعَ الْآخَرُ, the other one will be removed. يعني iman and shyness are two things that are one. If one of them is removed, the other one is removed. Al-Imam Hakim narrated this in his Mustadrak. يعني أنهما متلازمان. Both of them necessitate one another. لا ينفك أحدهما عن الآخر. One cannot be removed from the other one. They are strongly connected, both of them, iman and shyness. So when you see your iman, when you see your shyness going low, and you lack the quality of shyness, you know there's a direct effect on your iman. There's a problem with your iman. Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ لِكُلِّ دِينٍ خُلُقًا وَخُلُقُ الْإِسْلَامِ الْحَيَاءُ رَوَاهُ ابْنُ مَاجَهُ, that every single religion has a quality, a characteristics, a manner. And the manners of al-Islam is shyness. يعني every religion has a sajiyya shuri'at fihi, that it was legislated in it. Something that was given great importance in it. Something that was emphasized on in that religion. And that people were uniquely given to. And this religion, what it is that it is shyness. Shyness is that quality that is highly emphasized on in Islam. Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-haya'u min al-iman. Shyness is from iman. Wal-imanu fil jannah. And iman takes a person to jannah. Yufdi bi ahlihi ila al-jannah. That's what it means. Shyness takes the person to iman. And iman takes the person to jannah. وَالْبَذَاءُ مِنَ الْجَفَاءِ وَالْجَفَاءُ فِي النَّارِ. Vulgar speech, foul language is مِنَ الْجَفَاءِ, it is from harshness. It is from a person who possesses the quality of rudeness. A person who is distasteful. وَالْبَذَاءُ مِنَ الْجَفَاءِ وَالْجَفَاءُ فِي النَّارِ. And this quality of harshness is in the hellfire. رَاهُ التِّرْمِذِيُّ. Al-Imam al-Tirmidhiyu narrated this. Bukhari also narrated it in his Adab al-Mufrad. Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah authenticated it in his Silsila Hadith al-Sahiha. This hadith teaches us that shyness is from iman. And iman is a means for you to enter Jannah, my beloved brothers and sisters. Iman is a means for what? وَالْفَوْزُ بِنَعِيمِ الْجَنَّةِ. It's a means to attain the blessings of Jannah. The opposite of shyness in this hadith that's mentioned here is وَالْبَدَاءُ مِنَ الْجَفَاءِ. The person who's got no shyness. A person who's foul spoken, vulgar in their words, and when they speak, is definitely going to lead to the hellfire. Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he said that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said to لِلْأَشَجِّ الْعَصَرِي radiallahu ta'ala anhu, إِنَّ فِيكَ خَصْلَتَيْنِ. The Prophet said to this man, he said, this man was al-ashaj, meaning he had a wound on his head. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, inna fika khaslatayni, in you are two qualities. Yuhibbuhumullahu, Allah loves those two qualities that are in you. Al-hilma wal-haya'a, shyness and forbearance. You have two qualities that are in you. You have two qualities that are in you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. Allahu Akbar. The first one is al-hilm. Hilm means forbearance. You can endure what others say about you. You are a person when people are not nice to you, people cause you harm, people, you can show forbearance, endurance. And the second one is wal-haya'u, shyness. The hadith means أي جبلك الله على ذلك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this an innate quality for you. Because shyness, ما هو جبلي وما هو مكتسب. Shyness is two types, inshallah ta'ala, as we're going to see. There is a type which is jibilli, it's natural. And there's a type which is muqtasab, you have to work for it. You have to look for it. You have to study it. You have to discipline yourself on that type. And the people, brothers and sisters, mutafawitun. والناس mutafawitun. The people are not all of the same level when it comes to shyness. So it requires mujahada, fighting, striving, exerting efforts. Hafidh ibn Rajab al-Hanbali rahimahullah, he said, وَعَلَّمْ أَنَّ الْحَيَاءَ نَوْعَانِ. Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali, he said, no, that the shyness is two types. There are two types of shyness. The first one is مَا كَانَ خُلُقًا وَجِبِلَّةً غَيْرَ مُكْتَسَبٍ. That which is innate. مَا كَانَ خُلُقًا. Allah naturally just gave this person it. وَجِبِلَّةً. It's naturally built in this person. غَيْرَ مُكْتَسَبٍ. The person doesn't have to exert effort in it. وَهُوَ مِنْ أَجَلِّ الْأَخْلَاقِ الَّتِي يَمْنَحُهَا اللَّهُ الْعَبْدِ. And it is the greatest quality Allah bestows upon a slave. It is the best thing Allah gives a slave. وَلِذَلِكَ the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, Ibn Rajab says, الْحَيَاءُ لَا يَأْتِ إِلَّا بِخَيْرٍ. Shyness does not bring except that which is good. فَإِنَّهُ يَكُفُّ عَنْ إِرْتِكَابِ الْقَبَائِحِ وَدَنِيءِ الْأَخْلَاقِ. Shyness, what does it do? It removes from the person bad traits. It removes from this person for falling into that which is wrong and haram. It stops the person from what? Bad akhlaq and adab. وَيَحُثُّ عَلَى اسْتِعْمَالِ مَكَارِمِ الْأَخْلَاقِ. And it pushes the person towards good manners and good ethics. The second one he said is مَا كَانَ مُكْتَسَبًا. That which you have to work towards, you have to strive, you have to exert effort. مِنْ مَعْرِفَةِ اللَّهِ. By knowing Allah. وَمَعْرِفَةِ عَظَمَتِهِ. Knowing Allah, how great He is and how noble He is. وَقُرْبِهِ. And getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاطِّلَاعِهِ عَلَيْهِمْ. It is knowing that Allah is looking at you subhanahu wa ta'ala. That He knows subhanahu wa ta'ala خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. He knows the one who's deceiving. He knows what's in the chests. This one is the one you work on. You're always knowing Allah can see you subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is aware of what you're doing. Studying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's religion, learning about it, learning Allah's names and attributes. This one, it brings about shyness. And Ibn Rajab says, بَلْ هُوَ مِنْ أَعْلَى دَرَجَاتِ الْإِحْسَانِ. And this one is from the greatest levels of excellence. And the greatest levels of al-haya. That's powerful. So there are two types of shyness. Shyness which is natural, Allah gives it to the person. It's just natural for them. They don't need to look for it. Another one is muqtasab. You have to exert effort in. And everyone needs to do that one. Okay. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he said, مَرَّ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَى رَجُلٍ مِّنَ الْأَنصَارِ وَهُوَ يَعِظُ أَخَاهُ فِي الْحَيَاةِ. The messenger, he walked by a man from the people of Ansar. وَهُوَ يَعِظُ أَخَاهُ. He was advising his brother. He was advising his brother. He was talking to his brother. Giving him a lecture regarding shyness. And he was telling him, you're too shy, you know, stop being too shy. And he, get rid of that. And he's too shy, he was saying to him. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. And the messenger said to the one that was advising, he said to him, دَعْهُ, leave him alone. فَإِنَّ الْحَيَاءَ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. Shyness is from Iman. Leave him alone, the Prophet said, عليه الصلاة والسلام. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated that. وَاللَّفْضُ لِلْبُخَارِي. The wording is the wording of Al-Imam Bukhari. So, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prohibited a brother advising his brother regarding shyness. He said to him, do not advise him regarding shyness. Ali, do not tell him to leave off the quality of shyness. Why? Because shyness is what stops a person from doing that which is wrong. It is shyness, that which يَحُثُّ عَلَى اسْتِعْمَالِ مَكَارِمِ الْأَخْلَاقِ. Shyness is what makes you do good manners and good etiquettes. فَوَ خَيْرٌ كُلُّ. Shyness is all good. So some people, they say to somebody, Akhi, stop being shy, stop being shy, stop being shy. Shyness is always good. Haya, brothers and sisters, is min afdal al-khisal. It's the greatest characteristics, greatest trait a person has. It is that Allah gives to Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he mentioned that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, مَا كَانَ الْفُحْشُ فِي شَيْءٍ قَطٌ إِلَّا شَانَهُ. There is never vulgar, an indecency, an immorality is never present in something except that it makes it very ugly. وَلَا كَانَ الْحَيَاءُ فِي شَيْءٍ قَطٌ إِلَّا زَانَهُ. And there is not a matter where the person possesses shyness in this issue, إِلَّا زَانَهُ, except that it beautifies him. There isn't a person who comes with shyness in a matter except that it beautifies them. Rahu ibn Majah. There's not a situation where it was done with shyness except that you see the beauty in it. There is not a person who, when they do things, they do it with shyness. You can always see the beauty in it. So in this hadith is a isharatul ila adda al-khuluqa sayyi'a miftahu kulli shar. This hadith shows that every bad manners is the key to all evil. وَالْخُلُقَ الْحَسَنِ, good manners, is مِفْتَاحُ كُلِّ خَيْرٍ. Every good comes from it. And shyness is مِنْ أَعْظَمِ الْأَخْلَاقِ الْحَسَنَةِ. Shyness is the greatest quality of good manners. And if good manners has different things are good manners, right? The highest level is shyness. سلمان الفارسي رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, إِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ بِعَبْدٍ هَلَاكًا. If Allah wants to destroy a person, نَزَعَ مِنْهُ الْحَيَاءُ, Allah removes shyness from you. فَإِذَا نَزَعَ مِنْهُ الْحَيَاءُ, and if Allah removes shyness from you, لَمْ تَلْقَهُ إِلَّا مَقِيتًا وَمُمَقَّتًا. You will never meet this person who Allah removes from them shyness, except that you see this person immoral, distasteful, and despicable. That's the reality of a person who that quality has been taken from them. Any individual, Allah wants to destroy them, guess what he does to them? Salman al-Farisi is saying this. Allah removes from that person shyness. No longer shy. And then when shyness is removed from this person, you can't spend time with them. You're shy. So when you see these qualities, it scares you. It makes you distasteful towards them. You cannot spend a minute with them. Shyness is that thing, brothers and sisters, that stops us from doing wrong. If we don't have shyness, we do everything. That's why the Messenger said in the hadith Abu Mas'ud al-Badri radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet said this, إِنَّ مِمَّا أَدْرَكَ النَّأْسُ مِنْ كَلَامِ النُّبُوَّةِ الْأُولَىٰ إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاسْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ. That one of the things that was inherited, that was taken from the early prophets, the wise statement that was taken from them was what? إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي. إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحْيَا, if you're not shy. إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحْيِ فَاسْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ. If you're not shy, do as you wish. The person whose shyness is removed from them, لَا يُبَالِي فِي عَمَلِ, he doesn't care about his actions. وَلَا يَتَوَقَّى فِي أُمُورِ, and he's not diligent in what he does or say. He doesn't care. Shyness is that one thing that makes the person think, should I say this? Should I do this? Should I act in this particular way? Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali explains, إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاصْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ. If you're not shy, go do whatever you want. What does it actually mean, go do whatever you want? Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali says, فِي مَعْنَاهُ قَوْلًا. Regarding إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاصْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ, if you are not shy, do as you wish. There are two views regarding that. The first thing he says is, أَنَّهُ لَيْسَ بِمَعْنَى الْأَمْرِ. That the hadith, even though it seems like there's a command where you're being told to do something, فَاصْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ, go do whatever you want. But it's actually not a command. The first view is saying it's not a command. You're not being commanded to do something. So then, what am I being told? That within that group, there's two views within that group who say it's not a command. They have two views in there. The first ones they say, he said, أَنَّهُ أَمْرٌ بِمَعْنَى التَّهْدِيدِ وَالْوَعِيدِ. يعني it is, if you don't have shyness, then do as you wish. You don't have shyness, just go do whatever you want. In other words, the person's actually being warned. It's not, do as you wish. It's like ayah قوله تعالى, اعملوا ما شئتم. Do as you wish. إنه بما تعملون بصير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can see everything you're doing. And this ayah doesn't mean go commit sins and zina. No, it means if you do whatever you want, I will punish you. So it's a tahdeed, it's a warning in there. The The second view that believe it's not a command, they're saying it's khabar. It's a statement, which means أن من لم يستحي, the one who's not shy, صنع ما شاء, he does whatever he wishes. Because فإن المانع من فعل القبائح, the thing that prevents a person from doing that which is bad is what? Shyness. And shyness is no longer there, then what happens is that the person will go and do something bad. So it's a statement. It's informing us that shyness is the thing that stops a person from doing bad. And if they don't have shyness, then they are going to go out there and they're going to do bad. That's the first view who say it's not a command. There's a second view which says it's a command. Okay, the second view, they say it is a command. فَصْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ is a command. We should leave it at its apparent. We should leave it عَلَى ظَاهِرِ اللَّفْظِ, the way that the wording is. So then, okay, what does it mean then? They say it means إِذَا كَانَ الَّذِي تُرِيدُ فِعْلَهُ, if the thing that you want to do is مِمَّا لَا يُسْتَحْيَى مِنْ فِعْلِهِ, it's not something you should be generally shy about. And you shouldn't be shy about Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in regards to this action or speech, or you shouldn't be shy about the people, because it's a righteous action, it's a noble action, it's a good thing, then go out there and do it. That's what the hadith is saying, they said. So those are the two views regarding the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibn Rajab's kalam is very qawi, rahimahullah ta'ala. He said it in his kitab, Jami'ul Ulum wal Hikam, the first volume, page 498. My beloved brothers and sisters, shyness is a name from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Hayyu, ismu min asma'illahi al-husna. It's actually a name from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is two hadiths that have come that prove that it's a name from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first hadith is the hadith of Ya'la ibn Umayyah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ra'a rajulan, the messenger saw a man yaghtasilu bil barazi bila izarin. A man who was showering, who was cleaning himself, he was showering without covering himself. فَصَعِدَ الْمِنْبَرَ فَصَعِدَ, the Prophet ﷺ, he climbed الْمِنْبَرَ, the pulpit. فَحَمِدَ اللَّهُ وَأَثْنَى عَلَيْهِ, he praised Allah تبارك وتعالى, and then he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ حَيِّيٌ سِتِّيرٌ, Allah is shy and conceals. يُحِبُّ الْحَيَاءُ وَالسِّتْرُ, Allah loves shyness and he loves concealing. فَإِذَا اغْتَسَلَ أَحَدُكُمْ فَلْيَسْتَتِرُ, if one of you is cleaning himself and he's showering, then conceal yourself from the people. رواه أبو داود والنسائي. Abu Dawood and Nasa'i narrated this. So this hadith, it says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ حَيِّيٌ, Allah is حَيِّي. So حَيِّي is from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Good. The second hadith that shows that this is the name of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is hadith Salman al-Farisi radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إِنَّ رَبَّكُمْ حَيِّيٌ كَرِيمٌ يستحي من عبده إذا رفع يديه إليه أن يردهما صفرا. سلمان الفارسي, he said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that your Lord Allah عز وجل is حي كريم, Allah is حي shy, Allah سبحانه وتعالى is generous. يستحي, Allah is shy from what? من عبده, his slave. إذا رفع يديه, if he raises his hands and he begs his Lord, أن يردهما صفرا, that Allah turns back his hands without giving him what he asked for. Abu Dawood and Ibn Majah narrated this. So, Hayy is a name from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And min aqidati ahli sunnati wal jama'a is what? Allah's names are what? A'lamun bi'atibari dalalati ala al-dhat wa awsafun bi'atibari dalalati ala al-ma'ani. That Allah's names are not just mere names. Every name of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has a meaning in it. So we say that the name Al-Hayy has in there sifa, has a characteristics and attributes. And that attribute is what? Sifatul hayat, that Allah is shy subhanahu wa ta'ala. A shyness, taliqu bi jalalihi wa kamali, that befits his majesty. Yani it befits his majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah's characteristics subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's in a way that befits his majesty. لا يماثل أحدا من خلقي. Allah is never like his creation. So if it's a creation is shy and Allah is shy, we don't say it's the same. يعني the shyness of Allah, it's in a way that befits his majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala. ليس كمثله شيء. ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is nothing like him. And verily Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he can hear and he can see. We also believe رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما فاعبده واصطبر لعبادته هل تعلم له سميع. And there's nothing like him سبحانه وتعالى. Ibn al-Qayyim explained, he explained this name of Allah, Al-Hayy. He said, وَقَدْ وَصَفَ نَفْسَهُ بِالْحَيَاءِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he described himself to be one that's shy. وَوَصَفَ رَسُولُهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمَ. And Allah described his prophet to be one that is shy. We're going to come to the prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, how his shyness was alayhi salatu wasalam. فَهُوَ الْحَيِّيُّ الْكَرِيمُ. Allah is one who's shy and he's one who's generous. كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, as the messenger said, إن الله حيي كريم يستحي من عبده إذا رفع إليه يديه أن يردهما صفرا. That Allah is shy and that Allah is generous. If a slave raises his hands up in the air, that Allah does not turn you back for what you're asking. Allah gives you what you ask for. وقالت, this is a statement of Ibn Rajab. This is the statement of Ibn al-Qayyim I'm reading. Ibn al-Qayyim then says, وقالت أم السليمن. Umm Sulaiman said, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, Inna Allah la yastahi min al-haq. Allah is not shy from the truth. Wa qarraha ala dhalik. And the Messenger affirmed, he approved of her statement, Inna Allah la yastahi min al-haq, that Allah is not shy from the truth. Ibn al-Qayyim went on to saying, Wa qala al-Nabiyyu, the Messenger said, Inna Allah la yastahi min al-haq, Allah is not shy from the truth. La ta'tu al-nisa'a fi a'jazihinna. Do not come to the woman from there back passages. Do not. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that Allah is not shy. Inna Allah la yastahi min al-haq. Allah is not shy from the truth. So this hadith has shown us that we've taken before, and the statement of Ibn Rajab is that this characteristics of shyness is attributed to Allah azza wa jalla, and it is also attributed to our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abi Waqid al-Laythi radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, بينما هو جالس في المسجد, the prophet was sitting in the masjid, والناس معه, and the people were with the prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, إذ أقبل نفر ثلاثة, three men came forward, فأقبل اثنان إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وذهب واحد. Two of the men, they faced the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and one of them left. يعني two of them came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the third one he turned his back and he left. That's what he did. قال فوقف على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فأما أحدهما فرأى فرجة في الحلقة فجلس فيها وأما الآخر فجلس خلفهم وأما الثالث فأدبر ذاهبا. All of them, they stood upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One of them, he found a space and he sat there and he listened. Okay. The second one, what did he do? أما الآخر فجلس خلفهم. The second one, he went and he sat at the back. As for the third one, he turned his back and he left. When the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam finished, he said to the people, ألا أخبركم عن النفر الثلاثة. Shall I not tell you about these three men that came, their reality and their situation? The Sahaba, they said, of course, O Messenger of Allah. The Messenger then said, أما أحدهم. As for one of them, which is the first one, فأوى إلى الله فأواه الله. He came to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala came to him and he sheltered him. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala protected him. He came to the shelter of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and Allah gave him shelter. وأما الآخر, as for the second one, who sat at the back, فاستحيا, he was shy to push himself through. He was shy. فاستحيا, فاستحيا الله منه. Allah became shy from him. وأما الآخر, as for the third one, فأعرض, he turned away. فأعرض الله عنه. Allah turned away from him. What I want to take from the hadith is Allah was shy of the creation. If the creation is shy of Allah, Allah is shy of you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. نعم. فمن استحيا من الله, anyone is shy from Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, استحيا الله منه. Allah is shy from you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The reason is because Allah is hayyun. Allah is shy. يحب الحياء. He loves shyness. والواجب على العبد, what is upon every single one of us, my beloved brothers and sisters, is that we shy of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. We possess this quality of shyness that we come with it. روى الإمام أحمد رحمه الله في الزهد. Imam Ahmad narrated in his kitab الزهد. Bayhaqi also narrated in his kitab شعب الإيمان. أنا رجل قال للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أوصني. A man came to the Prophet and he said, يا رسول الله, advise me. I want you to advise me. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, أوصيك أن تستحي من الله كما تستحي رجلا صالحا من قومك. And Imam Ahmad and Bayhaqi narrated this hadith, that a man came to the Prophet and he said, Ya Rasulullah, awsini, advise me, O Messenger of Allah. The Messenger said to him, Usik, I advise you. The way I advise you is, أن تستحي من الله, that you are shy of Allah. كما تستحي, the way that you are shy from what? رجلا صالحا من قومك, the way that you are shy from a righteous man in your community. Ponder here. There are things you will never dare to do in front of your mother, your father. There are things you will never dare to do in front of a practicing imam, your local imam. You wouldn't do this in front of him. If that's what you're not going to do in front of the imam and your mother and your father, then why would you do this in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Why would you do this in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Now I'm going to mention three things that move the heart towards shyness. وَالَّذِي يُحَرِّكُ فِي الْقَلْبِ الْحَيَاءَ مِنَ اللَّهِ أُمُورٌ ثَلَاثَةٌ. There are three things that move the heart, that ignite the heart towards coming with this quality of shyness. The first one is رُؤْيَةُ نِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ تَبَارَكُ وَتَعَالَى عَلَيْكَ وَمِنَّتَهُ وَفَضْلَهُ. Looking at and thinking over the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on you, the blessings Allah bestowed upon you. Allah says in the Qur'an, in Surah Ibrahim, Ayah 34, Allah says, وَآتَاكُم مِّن كُلِّ مَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُ وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَظَلُومٌ كَفَّارٌ. Allah gave you all of the blessings you asked for. He gave you everything. And Allah then says, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ, if you sit down to try to count the blessings of Allah that He gave you, لَا تُحْصُوهَا, you can never ever put a figure to it. You can't say the blessings of Allah are 1,000 or 2,000. You can't. It's too much. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَظَلُومٌ كَفَّارٌ. Verily, mankind is oppressive and is one that does not show express gratitude to his Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second thing that will bring about, that will ignite the heart, that will push you towards shyness is رُؤْيَةُ تَقْصِيرِكَ فِي حَقِّهِ. Look at how deficient you are when it comes to the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقِيَامِكَ بِمَا يَجِبُ لَهُ عَلَيْكَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى مِنْ امْتِثَالِ الْمَأْمُورِ وَتَرْكِ الْمَحْذُورِ. وَقِيَامِكَ, and look at how you are when it comes to standing up to بِمَا يَجِبُ, that which is obligatory on you, the things that he told you to do, and the things that he told you to stay away from. Look at where are you regarding those things. Look how deficient we are regarding those things. Allah says in the Qur'an, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوْا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ. They are the ones who come with righteous actions. They do as they were told to do. They stay away from that which they were told to stay away from. وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ. With that said, like in their start, their hearts were still trembling. They are thinking that I haven't done enough. I haven't worshipped my Lord. I haven't done what He wanted from me. I haven't stayed away from that which He told me to stay away from. وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ. Their hearts are trembling. أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ. They know that they're going to return back to their Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is going to account them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third thing that pushes the heart, that moves the heart, is رُؤْيَةُ اطِّلَاعِهِ عَلَيْكِ. Knowing that Allah is always looking over you. فِي كُلِّ حَالٍ وَفِي أَيِّ وَقْتٍ. Allah is looking at you at every situation. فِي كُلِّ حَالٍ. Every situation of your life, Allah is looking at you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, observing you. وَفِي أَيِّ وَقْتٍ. And any time. مِنَ الْأَوْقَاتِ. All of the times of your life, Allah is looking over you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَيْنَمَا تَكُونَ. Wherever you are, He's looking over you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَوَلَا تَخْفَى عَلَيْهِ مِنْكَ خَافِيَةً. There is nothing hidden from Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, regarding your affairs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in Surah Al-Alaq, أَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَرَى. Do you not know that Allah can see you, subhanahu wa ta'ala? إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقِيبًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one that is observing you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says that we are aware of what you're saying to yourself, let alone what you do outside. We know what you whisper in your heart. Allah says in another ayah, يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ النَّاسِ وَلَا يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ مَعَهُمْ إِذْ يُبَيِّتُونَ مَا لَا يَرْضَى مِنَ الْقَوْلِ. They are shy of the people, and they are shy of what the people are going to say and what the people are going to do, but they are not shy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, I am with you, I am aware, I know, I can see everything that you're doing, the disbelief, the innovation, the sins that you're doing. I am aware of all of that. But ma'a dhalika, you don't act like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can see you. So these three things I mentioned are muharrikatul qulub. They move the heart. Towards what? Towards shyness. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives us this great quality of shyness. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the ability to do so. And Imam Ahmad rahimahullah narrated في مسنده in his musnad والترمذي في جامعه. And an Imam al-Tirmidhi also narrated in his jami' that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, and the Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, that the Prophet said, استحيوا من الله حق الحياء. Be shy of Allah the way He deserves. قلنا يا رسول الله, the Sahabas, then they said, إنا لنستحي ولله الحمد. We are shy of Allah and praises to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال, then the Messenger then said, ليس ذاك, that is not what I'm talking about. ولكن الاستحياء, rather the shyness is من الله, from Allah تبارك وتعالى, أن تحفظ الرأس وما وعى, is that you protect the head and everything around it, your ears, your eyes, your nose, your mouth, you protect it all. والبطن وما حوى, and you protect your stomach and everything in it. You don't eat that which is haram. وأن تذكر الموت والبلا, and that you remember death and the day that you're going to return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you remember the grave that you're going to go to, that is going to swallow you and your body is going to perish. وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةِ, and anyone who wants the hereafter, تَرَكَ زِينَةَ حَيَاتِ الدُّنْيَا, you leave off the glamours and the glitters of this dunya. فَمَنْ فَعَلَ ذَلِكَ, and anyone who does that, فَقَدْ إِسْتَحْيَى مِنَ اللَّهِ حَقَّ الْحَيَاءِ, then that person has truly become shy of Allah the way that they should be shy of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. The Messenger mentioned, أُمُورٌ أَرْبَعَةٌ فِيهَا جِمَاعُ الْخَيْرِ وَتَحْقِيقُ الْحَيَاءِ. Four things the Messenger mentioned. In those four things are the conclusion, the summary of all good. And in these four are the things that can bring about shyness to a person. The first and the second thing are, the first and the second. The first one is حِفْظُ الرَّأْسِ, protecting your head. And the second one is حِفْظُ الْبَطْنِ, protecting your tongue. Both of those affect shyness. They truly affect it. فَمَنْ كَانَ قَلْبُهُ عَامِرًا بِالْحَيَاءِ مِنَ اللَّهِ, anyone whose heart is filled up with shyness of Allah تبارك وتعالى, this shyness goes towards what? It goes towards حِفْظُ الرَّأْسِ. It goes to protecting your face and your eyes. You can't speak. Shy people can't talk. See how their mouth is protected. Shy people can't even look at you. They're very shy. Shy people don't listen. They're very nervous. The nervousness and the shyness that they have, they don't listen to wrong things. So shyness affects the ears. It also affects the stomach. People who are shy can't eat in front of other people, mentally. You see that. They don't eat that which is haram. They stay away from that which is haram. The quality of shyness protects your ears, your eyes, your nose, your mouth, your stomach. حِفْظُ الرَّأْسِ. حِفْظُ الْبَصَرِ, which is the eyes. They don't look at which is haram. They don't listen to that which is haram. They don't say that which is haram. Their face is not directed towards that which is haram. And they don't prostrate to anyone other than Allah. They only prostrate to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. The ones that are shy, they do not eat and put into their stomachs that wealth that's stolen, the money taken from riba. They don't. They do not use money that's taken from deception, and etc. And then the hadith mentioned two other things at the end. And what are the two things? وَأَن تَذْكُرَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْبِلَىٰ وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةَ تَرَكَ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. These two things are also the quality of shyness, which is remembering death consistently and continuously. The one who has shyness, the death is always on his mind. He knows he's going to depart from this world, but he's not going to stay for too long. This is not his place of eternity. This is not a place he was created for. He was not created for this dunya, but rather he was created for the hereafter. He knows that this is just a stepping stone, a place he just needs to accumulate righteous actions. He knows all of that. And he knows that he shouldn't beautify himself excessively in this dunya, that the beauty is for the day of judgment. The beauty is to beautify your grave with righteous deeds, not your house in this world that you're going to leave. That is the quality of shyness, those four. Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أشد حياء من العذراء في خدرها وكان إذا كره شيئا عرفناه في وجهه متفق عليه. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was excessively shy. He was even more shyer than a virgin woman who is in her inner chamber. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if shyness overcame him and he was shy of something someone said and he couldn't, he was too shy of it and he disliked it, عَرَفْنَاهُ فِي وَجْهِ We can recognize it from his face, عليه الصلاة والسلام. Our messenger, عليه الصلاة والسلام, had this quality. He was more shy than what? A virgin. A woman who's a virgin, who's never been married, who's never been spoken to a man before, has no relationship with a man. When she first talks to him, she's very nervous, very agitated. She's shy, she sweats, she breathes heavily. The word won't even come out of her mouth. This is Nabiullah Muhammad, alayhi salatu wassalam. If you look at that quality, do we find it in our young sisters today? Do we find this quality in our brothers today? Is it present in them? What, look at what the Prophet was compared to. He was compared to a virgin, a woman. The shyness should be a high quality for women, and without a doubt, it also should be for the men. Look at this story. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said about the night of Isra wal Mi'raj, when the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, usriya bi Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Messenger was taken high up. Qala Rasulullah, the Messenger said, faradallahu ala ummati 50 salata. The Messenger said about that night, my ummah, it was prescribed on them 50 prayers. Qala, the Prophet said, فَرَجَعْتُ بِذَلِكَ حَتَّى أَمُرَّ بِمُوسَى. The Prophet took those 50 prayers and he crossed in him, and he came by Musa alayhi salam. فَقَالَ مُوسَى, Musa said to him, مَاذَا فَرَضَ رَبُّكَ عَلَى أُمَّتِكَ. What is it that your Lord has prescribed onto your people when it comes to the prayer? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, فَرَضَ عَلَيْهِمْ 50 صَلَاتًا. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he made obligatory on them what? 50 salatan, 50 prayers. Qala li Musa, Musa said to me, faraji' rabbaka, go back to your Lord. Fa inna ummataka la tutiqu dhalik, your ummah can't do this. The Prophet then, he said, faraja'tu rabbi, I went to my Lord, fawada'a shatraha, he removed half of that from me. So 25 left. Faraja'tu ila Musa, I came back to Musa. And then Musa said to me, what are the prayers that your Lord has made obligatory onto you? I said to him, my Lord has made obligatory on me this much prayers. He said, Raji' Rabbaka, go back to your Lord. فَإِنَّ أُمَّتَكَ لَا تُطِيقُ ذَلِكَ, your ummah can't do this. And then he said to me, how much? And then I told him, he said, go back and tell your Lord to change this from you. فَرَاجَعْتُ رَبِّي, the Prophet said, I went back to my Lord. فَقَالَ, he then said, هِيَ خَمْسٌ وَخَمْسُونَ لَا يُبَدَّلُ الْقَوْلُ لَدَيَّ فَرَاجَعْتُ إِلَى مُوسَى. Then the prayer got pushed down to 5. I came to Musa again. And when Musa was, يعني نبي الله محمد was given 5 prayers, but the reward is 50. And this will not be changed, it was said to the Prophet. Then I went to Musa, he said, the Prophet. فَرَجَعْتُ إِلَى مُوسَى, I went back to Musa. فَقَالَ, he said to me, رَاجِعَ رَبَّكَ, go back to your Lord and speak to him about it. فَقُلْتُ, I said, قَدْ إِسْتَحْيَيْتُ مِنْ رَبِّي, I am shy of my Lord. I can't go to him after this. This is the part I want from the hadith. Our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was shy. He said, I can't go back to my Lord, I'm too shy from him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, يُحَدِّثُ أَنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam كَانَ يَنْقُلُ مَعَهُمُ الْحِجَارَةُ وَلِلْكَعْبَةِ وَعَلَيْهِ إِزَارُهُ. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is before Islam. This was days of Mecca. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was removing some rocks from the Kaaba in order to build the Kaaba with Quraysh. With him was his uncle Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was carrying the rock. And then Abbas said to him, I have an idea for you. Abbas said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why don't you just take your cloth, connect it on your neck, which would then necessitate the Prophet's aura to be seen. His lower garment, he said, connect it on your neck, then the Prophet's private part will be seen. He said to him, فَقَالَ لَهُ الْعَبَّاسُ عَمُّهُ يَبْنَ أَخِي لَوْ حَلَّلْتَ إِزَارَكَ, if you just tie your on your shoulders, فَجَعَلْتَهُ عَلَى مَنْكِبِكَ دُونَ الْحِجَارَةِ, because then it can save you from the stone going onto your body. The Messenger then said, okay, فَحَلَّهُ عَلَى مَنْكِبَيْهِ, the Prophet tied it to his shoulders. فَسَقَطَ مَغْشِيًا عَلَيْهِ, the Prophet, as soon as he was doing that, he fell down on the ground, he fainted. Because Allah doesn't want his slave, Muhammad ibn Abdullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's aura to show. So the Prophet fainted straight away. فَمَا رُؤِيَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ عُرْيَانًا. The messenger from that day onwards, no one ever saw him. Muttafaqun alayhi, Bukhari and Muslim both narrated it. ولذلك he was very shy alayhi salatu wasalam. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, بُنِيَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ بِزَيْنَبَ بِنْتِ جَحْشٍ بِخُبْزٍ وَلَحْمٍ. The messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he married Zaynab bint Jahsh. This was the banquet of Zaynab bint Jahsh. And the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, meat and bread was being served to the people. Anas ibn Malik, he said, فَأُرْسِلْتُ عَلَى الطَّعَامِ. The food was given to me and I was told to call the people, invite the people to eat. Anas ibn Malik, he said, فَيَجِيءُ قَوْمٌ فَيَأْكُلُونَ وَيَخْرُجُونَ. A group of people will come, they will eat and they will leave. Another group of people will come, they will eat and they will leave. Another group of people will come and they will eat and they will leave. فَدَعَوْتُ حَتَّى مَا أَجِدُ أَحَدًا أَدْعُو. Anas ibn Malik, he said, I called until I couldn't find anyone else to come and eat. Everyone has eaten. فَقُلْتُ يَا نَبِيَ اللَّهِ. Anas said, I went to the Prophet, I said, O Messenger of Allah, مَا أَجِدُ أَحَدًا أَدْعُو. I can't find anyone to call. مَا أَجِدُ أَحَدًا أَدْعُوهُ. I can't find anyone to call. The messenger then said to him, اِرْفَعُوا طَعَامَكُمْ. Raise your food. يعني, carry your food. وَبَقِيَ ثَلَاثَةُ رَحْطٍ يَتَحَدَّثُونَ فِي الْبَيْتِ. Three men, they stayed in the Prophet's house. They were chatting and they were talking. The messenger, صلى الله عليه وسلم, he then left. فَانْطَلَقَ إِلَى حُجْرَةِ عَائِشَةِ. He went to the house of Aisha. فقال, he said to Aisha, السلام عليكم أهل البيت ورحمة الله. He said, salam be upon the family here, referring to Aisha. May Allah's mercy be upon you, Aisha. He said to her, how are you? She said, وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. كيف وجدت أهلك. How are you? She said, Alhamdulillah. How have you found your wife, your new wife? She said to him, referring to Zaynab bint Jahsh. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, خير بارك الله لك. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessing be upon you. فتقرى حجر نسائه. Then the messenger went to the other wives' houses, asking them, يقول لهن, saying to them that which he said to Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها. How are you? How is everything? And they will all say to him, كما قالت عائشة, that which Aisha said, which is, how's your new family? How's your new wife? The messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم came back to the house and the three men were still there talking and chatting. This is what I want from the hadith. They are in his house, just sitting there talking. He felt very uncomfortable for them to be that long. But look what he did. وَكَانَ النَّبِيُّ صلى الله عليه وسلم شَدِيدَ الْحَيَاءِ. He was a very shy person, عليه الصلاة والسلام. فَخَرَجَ مُنْطَلِقًا. When he saw them still sitting there, he left. He went to Aisha's house again. Aisha then said, فَمَا أَدْرِي أَخْبَرْتُهُ أَمْ أُخْبِرَ. I don't remember. Was it me who told him that they left? Or was it someone else that told him that they left? يعني أن القوم خرجوا. فرجع. The Prophet went back and he went into his house, عليه الصلاة والسلام. And that's when the ayah of hijab came down. Rather, Allah تبارك وتعالى send the ayah down. قوله تعالى, إن الله لا يستحي من الحق. Allah is not shy from the truth. يعني إذا دخلتم, if you enter the house of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and you're in his house, then don't just sit around and be there for that. يعني the Sahabas were rebuked. But ayah came down to say that. The Prophet was so shy to say it, عليه الصلاة والسلام. Shyness, a quality that one should have. Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها, she said, سألت امرأة, a woman asked, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, she asked the Prophet, كيف تغتسل من حيضتها? How should a woman clean herself from her menstruation? فذكرت أنه علمها كيف تغتسل. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Aisha said, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم taught her how to do it. كيف تغتسل. ثم تأخذ فرصة من مسك فتطهر بها. Then the woman should take a cotton where there's misk on it and she should clean herself with it. The woman then said, كيف أتطهر بها? How do I clean myself with that cotton? Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, تطهري بها, clean it with yourself. سبحان الله, he said. واستتر, and then he hid himself, عليه الصلاة والسلام. سفيان بن عيينة mentioned, بيده على وجهه, and he covered his face, عليه الصلاة والسلام, when he said that. قالت عائشة, Aisha then said, وجتذبتها, I grabbed the woman, إلي, towards my direction. وعرفت, I realized, ما أراد النبي, that which my husband, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, was intending to say. فقلت, I said to her, تتبعي بها أثر الدم. What the Prophet is saying to you is that where the blood went on, run that place with that cotton with the blood on it. متفق عليه, Bukhari and Muslim both narrated that. وفي رواية للحديث, there's another riwayah which is استحيا فعرض عنها. The Prophet became so shy from the woman's question, he turned his face away. He couldn't look at her. عليه الصلاة والسلام. الله أكبر. And then we have people today that speak vulgar, foul language. Everything that comes to their mouth, they say it. And no, they don't care. Sometimes they joke about it. Sometimes they laugh about it. That's Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's teaching the religion, but he's so shy when she went that far to explain it more. That that Aisha had to grab the woman's and grab her towards her and tell her. This was not unique to the Prophet, by the way, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is something that the Sahabas also had. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu narrated, he said, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the messenger said, أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر. The most merciful person to my ummah is Abu Bakr. وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر. The one that's the most staunch on the commandments of Allah is Umar. Umar is very strong in that regard. وأصدقهم حياء, and the most shyest of them all is Uthman. وأقرأهم لكتاب الله أبي بن كعب. And the one who knew the Quran the most is Ubay ibn Ka'b. وأفرضهم زيد بن ثابت. And the one that knew the fara'id, inheritance, the most is Zayd ibn Thabit. وَأَعْلَمُ بِالْحَلَالِ وَالْحَرَامِ. And the one that knows the halal and the haram the most is Mu'adh ibn Jabal. Then the messenger then said, أَلَا وَإِنَّ لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ أَمِينًا. Every ummah has a trustworthy, reliable person. وَإِنَّ أَمِينَ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ. The one that's the Ameen of this ummah is none other than Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah رضي الله تعالى عنه. So look at Uthman رضي الله عنه. Uthman's shyness reached the extent that the angels were shy of him because of the shyness that he had. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she mentioned, قالت, she said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مضجعا. The Prophet was lying down. في بيتي, in my house. كاشفا عن فخذي. The Prophet's thighs were showing. أو ساقيه, or his shins. فاستأذن أبو بكر. Abu Bakr knocked on the door and he asked for permission if he can come in. The messenger stayed the way he was, lying down, and his thighs or his shin was showing. Didn't move. Salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. Then Umar radiallahu anhu. ثم استأذن عمر. Umar knocked on the door and he said, Ya Rasulullah, can I come in? The Prophet let him in and did not change his position in the way he was. Still lying down, his thighs or his chin was showing. Salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. ثم استأذن عثمان. Uthman sought permission. فجلس رسول الله. The messenger sat down. وسوى ثيابه. And the Prophet, he hid his shins or his thighs. He hid it, salawatullahi wa salam alayhi. Aisha was looking, she was pondering. She could see her father come in. The Prophet didn't change. She could see Umar come in. The Prophet didn't change. So Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, I asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She said, dakhala Abu Bakrin. Abu Bakr entered onto you. Lam tahtasha, you did not move. وَلَمْ تُبَالِي, you didn't give any consideration to his entrance. يعني you didn't change the way your situation was. ثُمَّ دَخَلَ عُمَرُ. Umar entered, you didn't change. فَلَمْ تَحْتَشَّ وَلَمْ تُبَالِهِ, you didn't give any change or nothing significant happened to you. You stayed the way that you were. ثُمَّ دَخَلَ عُثْمَانُ. And Uthman entered. فَجَلَسْتَ وَسَوَّيْتَ ثِيَابَكَ. You sat down. You sat up before you let him in. You covered yourself and your thighs and your knees. And then you said, and you sat down and you spoke to him. Why? Then the messenger then said, أَلَا أَسْتَحِي مِنْ رَجُلٍ تَسْتَحِي مِنْهُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. Should I not be shy of a man that the angels are shy of? Al-Imam Muslim narrated this hadith. Ali ibn Abi Talib was also the same, was a shy companion. He said, كُنْتُ رَجُلًا مَذَّاءً. I was a man who suffered from continuous semen used to come from me. وَكُنْتُ أَسْتَحِي. I was very shy. And أسأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما كانت ابنته. I couldn't ask the Prophet the question, what do I do in this situation? Every time this lubricant comes from me, what should I do? He said, I didn't know how to go to the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام and talk to him and say to this, because of his daughter I'm married to. فأمرت, but I still want to know the truth. I want to know the حق, and I want to know the ruling in this issue. فأمرت, I went to مقداد بن الأسود. I said, مقداد, go to the Prophet and ask this question for me. Miqdad went and he asked the Prophet. The messenger said, يَغْسِلُ ذَكَرَهُ وَيَتَوَضَّ. He just has to wash his private part and do wudu. Muttafaqun Ali, Bukhari, Muslim both narrated that. Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said, وَكُنْتُ أَسْتَحِي. I was shy. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, I mentioned some examples for the brothers. I'm going to now mention an example for the sisters. Our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, كنت أدخل بيتي الذي دفن فيه رسول الله. I used to enter my house that the Prophet was buried in. I used to enter it. وأبي, and my father was also buried in there. فأضع ثيابي, I'll take off all my clothes. Sisters, please ponder on this. Please, sisters, listen to this. Aisha saying, I will enter my house in which the Prophet was buried inside it. And my father Abu Bakr was buried inside it. I will take off my clothes. I will take off my hijab. وأقول, I would say to myself, إنما هو زوجي وأبي. The only people who are in the house with me are my father and the Prophet. فلما دفن عمر, when Umar was buried inside it, with my father and the Prophet. فوالله, I swear by Allah, ما دخلت, I never entered it. إلا وأنا مشدودة علي ثيابي, that I was fully covered. I had my hijab on, in my own house. حياء من عمر, I was shy of عمر. عمر is dead. عمر is buried there. Aisha said, I'm still shy. Shyness, quality. Imagine that from someone who's dead. Sisters, imagine someone who is alive and looking at you in front of you. You take off your hijab, they see you. You don't wear your hijab properly. You don't cover yourself properly. Imagine that. Shyness. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, قالت, she said, جاءت فاطمة بنت عتبة بن الربيعة. فاطمة بنت عتبة بن الربيعة came to بايع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. She came to give pledge of allegiance to the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. فأخذ عليها, the prophet gave her pledge of allegiance based on the ayah, ألا يشركن بالله شيئا ولا يسرقن ولا يزنين. الآية. قالت, Aisha said, فوضعت يدها على رأسها حياء. She placed her hand on her head out of shyness. فأعجب رسول الله, the messenger was amazed by what he saw, ما رأى منها, that which he saw from her. فقالت عائشة, Aisha then said, أقري أيتها المرأة. Say, I affirm what the Prophet just said to you. فوالله ما بايعنا إلا على هذا. Aisha said, there was no other way that the bay'ah was ever done except for the women, only by the mouth. فنعم إذن فبايعها بالآية. The Prophet gave her a bay'ah based on that. صلى الله عليه وسلم. الحياء مطلوب. Brothers and sisters, shyness is required from every one of us. We need to come with it. But shyness should not be the thing that stops us from seeking knowledge and attaining Islamic understanding of our religion. We need to learn our deen. We need to understand our deen. Shyness is not running away from learning the deen. Some people think that's what it is. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, نِعْمَ النِّسَاءُ نِسَاءُ الْأَنصَارِ نِعْمَ النِّسَاءُ نِسَاءُ الْأَنصَارِ. Wallahi, blessed are the women of the Ansar. Aisha saying this. لَمْ يَمْنَعْهُنَّ الْحَيَاءُ أَنْ يَتَفَقَّهْنَا فِي الدِّينِ. Shyness did not stop them from learning the religion. Don't be shy of the truth and learning the religion. وَلِذَلِكَ أُمُّ سُلَيْمٍ, she said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَسْتَحْيِي مِنَ الْحَقِّ. أُمُّ سُلَيْمٍ said, O Messenger of Allah, Allah is not shy from the truth. هَلْ عَلَى الْمَرْأَةِ مِنْ غُسْلٍ. Does a woman have to do ghusl? إِذَا احْتَلَمَتْ, if she has a wet dream. If a woman has a wet dream, should she do a shower from it? Does she have to clean herself from it? The Prophet said, نعم إذا رأت الماء. If something comes out of her, any liquid, then yes, she has to do ghusl. Mujahid ibn Jabrin commented on that hadith and he said, لا يتعلم مستحن ولا متكبر. A person, لا يتعلم مستحن, a person who is shy, ولا متكبر, will not learn. A shy person and an arrogant person will never learn. I'm going to conclude there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now. Click like and subscribe. And don't forget to make that intention.